When I was a child, I had to go through a surgery, and my dad brought me a box of macarons from a place called Josephine in Paris. And I remember as a child being in hospital with my box of macarons, you know, like when you're given like a chocolate box, or as a kid, it's a bit unusual. So I remember back then eating my macarons one by one, little by little, to enjoy them. In making them, I fell in love eating them before that. But making them, like, I had no idea before how to make them, how, what the process was, or how hard it was, or anything. And once I got my hands in there, I really enjoyed like the hard work, all the different steps that involve making a perfect macaron. It's not just like making a tray of brownie, you know, where you have a tray and just chop your slices. It's very different because you make things one by one. So it's really the way you shape your dough, the way it's gonna bake, then the way you fill them and you close them. It's many little steps that makes the perfect looking macaron, nice, round, petite, and you want it to look very gourmand. Like you want something pretty and appealing, and that's the first thing that will catch your eye. And that will, I guess, the brain sends a message to your tummy, then to your stomach, saying, I want to eat you then. So I came to Australia after, like, so I had been working in Paris for a while. I was a bit bored of my life there, so I needed a year break, wanted to come to travel, and why not buy a van and travel around Australia. I had to choose between Sydney, Melbourne. The flights were cheaper to land in Melbourne, so that's where I arrived. And instantly, I really, really loved the city. At first, I was waitressing in a catering company. I offered them to sell my macaron for their function and stuff like that. Then, when the business was growing, I needed to bake in a commercial kitchen, so I was subletting their kitchen at night. And then the business grew and allowed me then to have a deposit to set up this place. Macaron involves so much work that it's definitely a work of art. All the craftsmanship that's involved makes it like a little jewel, you know.